生有事。Okay guys, thank you for tuning in another video. In this video we're going to find out if this valve is big enough to roll the entire Harrier model. We're going to use the CNC services from PCBWay to make this printed part out of aluminium. And today we have a very special guest who actually upscaled his Kestrel to a 120 size. So bigger motors, bigger momentum, bigger airplane. And we're going to tune the KK2 board, this one. And yeah, it will arrive in 2 hours, so lots of work for preparation. And hopefully in this video we're going to perform a vertical takeoff and hover. We're going to do, hopefully, but I think so, because we've got a lot of experience with new models, to do a normal takeoff, going to into inbound transition, and then a vertical landing, and all in this video. So guys, I would say take a nice cup of coffee, relax, and enjoy this video. Let's work. So the next step is to continue with the elevator parts. Like I told you in the last video, these are going to fit inside of this. So we slide them in, both on the same side. To make it stronger, we're going to fit a carbon rod of 5 millimeters. And then we got a really super strong joint inside of this part. So we're looking forward. So let's continue. And we need to rush because we got 2 weeks left to build this Harrier and to fly it in Ter Apel. So maiden flight soon, guys. Please turn on that notification bell. Subscribe if you didn't. And be a witness of our maiden flight. Okay, very happy. The new tilt section is finished and it feels super, super stable. So let's continue with the rest of the fuselage. Well guys, I'm really happy with the new stabilization of the tilt section of the Harrier. And yeah, this is going to hold very well. Super stable. Also the axis is stable, so I think this will be a really nice part. So during flight, this should hold. So really pleased with this part. Okay, new front section. It's starting to look like an airplane again, and everything is well aligned this time. So super happy about this. So now it's really easy also to install the Pegasus. And here we got our improvement parts for the Pila CF that we can screw in these tubes. So this will fit here. And I will make some shattered parts, and then you will fit this in to fix the top wing. So this is going to be a big improvement. Wow, we are getting the silver award. Super, super, super cool. Wow. Okay guys, the Pegasus is installed. And thank you Melanie for filming the video. So also the improvement parts are there, and we're going to attach the wings with 4 bolts and 2 carbon slides. The Pegasus is running again, and we're now going to proceed with opening those holes and put on the new tail. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's do our first test with this roll valve. This is the bigger roll valve. Wow. Wow. Okay guys, happy that you're still with in the video. A really nice package has arrived. So we're going to convert those printed parts with, or swap them with, aluminium parts. So thank you PCBWay for sending these parts to help us with the Harrier project. Let's find out. Okay guys, ordering at PCBWay is super, super easy. Once you set up your account, you go to the top side of the webpage, you select CNC services, and just get started. Beware that you prepare your part before and save it as a step, because you want to upload your part directly from your files into the website.
PCBWay is going to calculate the price, select the quantity of material, and mostly I'll use like 2. And I will select the aluminium 7075, which is my favorite lightweight and most used aluminium in the RC community. Submit your price and you will get your quote in a few days. They will check it out. And also it's really nice to preview your parts before submitting it to PCBWay. I'm very happy with PCB services and they meant a lot for me. So thank you so much, PCBWay. And this is how the landing gear looks out. So the quality is super nice, super clean. And yeah, I'm really happy with these parts. And they are also very lightweight. Wow, this looks brilliant. Way more better. Awesome. Okay, wings attached. I'm really happy with the airflow. So it pushes really, really hard compared to these small ones. So version 1, version 2 is a big valve, but I need to reprint the wing again because I made a mistake. It's solid printed, except for the tube. So, again, more printing work, so more delay, sorry. Tail is getting assembled, and also some new parts of the tail is getting printed because I made a mistake too there. I'm now using a 65mm. And before I had a 50mm, so we are increasing the push defector. And yeah, what to do now actually? Actually, is waiting for the parts for the Harrier, and I will adjust the files again so the servos will fit. Small mistake happens when you work too much. So I think we're going to continue with the Kestrel project. Next week we're going to fly in Ter Apel, so I want to finish my Kestrel as well. And also Marco will arrive soon. Okay guys, so hopefully we're going to finish the Harrier next week and prepare it for its maiden flight, normal takeoff and vertical landing. So this procedure, normal takeoff and vertical landing, we're going to perform with the Kestrel today. At least this is the goal. And it got a challenge. So Marco upscaled his model with 120%. 120% version. And normally we are using those 90s from JP, which are pretty awesome. With the big FD5, I've been using 90mm, and Marco is going to use 90mm as well. The challenge is that I programmed the KK2 board with a 12S setup, so this is a different KV motor. Marco is going to use a 6S setup, which is a higher KV motor. So for tuning the KK2 board, I need to squeeze out, lower the limits, and found out the ultimate settings. And guys, I have to be honest with you, this is not as easy as it looked like, but I try to explain in the next shots what we did. So we're going to play with PID, we're going to play with volumes to the motor, and we're going to reduce I, play a little bit around with auto level, and see if we get this big Kestrel stable. Okay guys, this is a really special project. Enlarged to 120%. Okay. Mine is small, need to build a new one. You are fat. So huge. Really nice, preparing for first flight. Okay guys, I'm going to try to walk you through the process of tuning the KK2 board. So this is our first attempt, roughly downloaded from the Kestrel, and you see directly there's clearly overshoot. So in this next test, we're going to lower down the PID settings and let's see what this works. So we started to lower the P. And this resulted already nicely in some more smoother, less oscillations, but we still got a big wobble and it feels quite sluggish. So we higher the auto level settings, lower the I settings. I feel more control, but it still does the oscillations. So we are now checking the settings and compare it with the big F35. These have 130, so we're going to look for settings in between the 130 millimeter and the 70 millimeter. And again, we have still control, but we still got a heavy oscillation there. In this next test, we are lowering the eye settings. So less error in the movement, and this looks already quite promising. I have to admit, there's a lot of wind during this test, and that's why it's also really difficult to tune it in the garden, especially for this big size model. Okay, nice takeoff, not enough ground effects, so it takes off really easy. And here I'm starting to feel really control. It's still really difficult. Okay. And but we are starting to get control as well. So now in this last test, we go into higher actually the auto level settings. And we lowered quite a lot the eye settings. So they are all the settings are half compared to how we started. And here we have a quite controllable hover. So basically less volume, less elevator volume to the pitch. We are using thrust differential to pitch the entire model. And you can see that we have control in this video. So we're super happy, and let's bring her to the field. Okay, here we are ready for some field testing. I have to mention there is a lot of wind, but yeah, we need to fly and test more to tune the KK2 board and to see how it controls and how it behaves during windy conditions. So this is a good test. In this shot, you can actually see that the hard work in that afternoon paid really off. We are super happy. And it feels controllable, and the behavior is actually predictive. So no crazy oscillations, and she's handling well with the wind. So time for a second attempt. We're going to gain a higher climb to really escape the ground effects. And here you go. We got a really super stable hover. It feels super natural. We are hovering at 50% of the lipo capacity. Marco decided to go for a 2-pack 6S parallel to gain longer flight time. And she's handling really, really well with the wind. So next week in Ter Apel, we're going to tune it a little bit more. It feels actually naturalized like a helicopter actually. But we are enjoying this moment amazingly. So it's actually also time to do a maiden flight, and I would say enjoy this video. Yes, the takeoff was really nice, and she's climbing really fast as well, so lots of power there. So the idea is to do a circuit, two circuits, and we will perform a vertical landing. So once we get out of the second corner, and the sound is really amazing. It sounds like a turbine.
Yeah.
We are flying now at 70% throttle. It's a windy day, so I like to keep a little bit throttle there to have some speed, but she's behaving very well. So we're going into our approach. Lowering the throttle back to 50%, 40%. And we will then finally hit that transition switch and listen to that sound. Really, really smooth. And all the time I was thinking, this is not my airplane, this is Marco. So if I crash it, I need to build a new model. But look at it, really beautiful, super controllable. And let's land her gently. Marco, congrats with your nice build of the airplane. Super happy. Okay guys, I'm ending this monster edit. And oh, look, you got the X32, the Castro, the Harrier. And thank you all for watching. Make sure to give me a thumbs up if you like this video, subscribe if you didn't, and hopefully soon we can show you our YouTube play button. Thank you so much for watching, and leave a nice comment, and see you next time. Bye bye.